Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the show. Now, the Olympics are over and all of the athletes are headed back home. But there was a little snag with Team Great Britain, who bought all of their Olympians matching red bags, right? Which led to this unfortunate scene at baggage reclaim. I mean, imagine if you were on that flight and you had a red bag too. Do you know what I mean? You get off the plane, you're like, yeah, no, I'll meet you at the taxi stand. I'm just going to, oh, come on. So find out whose luggage was whose. They had to go through all of them. And they're like, okay, which one of you had in your suitcase a complimentary Olympics T-shirt? Everyone? Okay, who had a water bottle? Like, if I was someone who didn't win a medal, like, I'd have been like, yeah, that sounds like two golds and a silver. I'm good, I'm out. I'll see you later, guys. Bye. But this all happened after the seating arrangement on the plane, which was actually organised by how many medals you won, right? This is true. Medal winners sat in first and business class, while people who didn't get a medal sat in coach, right? Truly, this is what first class looked like. And this is what it looked like in coach, look. You just know there's a fourth place winner trying to talk his way into first class. Like, he'd beat me by like 0.02 seconds. Come on. This is so crazy. In fact, at customs, when asked if they had anything to declare, non-medal winners were like, yeah, this is bull. It's too bad America didn't use that same class system. Like, Simone Biles, Michael Phelps, you get first class. Ryan Lochte, yeah, you can swim home. In the States, after Donald Trump recently questioned Hillary Clinton's physical fitness, a lot of journalists are taking a closer look at Trump's doctor, who gave Trump a clean bill of health late last year, and they're finding that he's actually lied about some of his medical credentials. Here's a picture of Trump's doctor, Dr. Harold Bornstein. I mean, that is a face that says, you're going to want a second opinion. Look at that photo again. I mean, look at him, right? Here's a list of things I would trust that man with, right? Repairing a broken lava lamp. Recommending the top five trombone albums. And airbrushing a naked lady on the side of your van. That's it, but fortunately for Trump, all the attention has been on his running mate, Mike Pence, who's been grabbing headlines today thanks to a Facebook Live video of him getting a 20-minute haircut. Wow. Riveting. Look out, Chewbacca mom. 20 minutes. The craziest part of this video is the guy cutting his hair didn't know who Mike Pence was until after he was done. And watch how he reacts when Pence tells him that he's running with Donald Trump.
Your name, Mike Pence.
Mike Pence.
Yes, I'm the governor of the state of Indiana. Okay. Running for vice president of the United States.
Go ahead, man.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Oh, boy.
I'm running with Donald Trump, so I'm his running mate.
Okay, all right.
All right. And right after that, he told him he was Trump's running mate, the barber was like, no, do you know what? I actually missed the spot. Let me, and then he did this.